All right, so I'd like to start off with our first group of pests, which are rodents. So typically the first one that you're going to find around a farm area, agriculture, is going to be a house mouse. We're pretty familiar with a house mouse. You know, it's a small gray animal. It's got a light underbelly. They're around about 2.5 up to 4 inches in length, but they've got a small feet, small head, but in proportion to their body, they do have large eyes and ears. And that comes in to where you can distinguish a full-grown mouse from a young brown rat or Norway rat, because with mice, their feet are going to be small, where you're going to have a young rat, their hind feet are going to be large. And also their ears and eyes are going to be smaller on a rat than you will have on a mouse. So we do have mice that could be running around the confinement area or any of your agriculture buildings, whether it's grain or anything like that. So let's kind of think about, well, how do I know I've got a mouse infestation? So let's think about the infestation signs. What are you going to be seeing? Typically, you're going to see the droppings. So the droppings are going to be about 1/4 inch in length, and they're pointed at the ends. And you can find those along the walls. Maybe you'll find them on the ground or around the feed or anywhere like that. So droppings are going to be a key indication. Gnawing damage is another one. They like to gnaw their way into a hiding area or into where they're going to be feeding. So if you look at my picture on the lower right, you'll see a hole where a mouse gnawed through this door and got inside. Another thing, that sign could be burrowing. The two pictures I have here, you've got one in the middle that shows mouse burrowing into the ground near this greenhouse. You can have them burrowing into insulation. So knowing what you're finding holes around your building, that could be an indication of a mouse nesting. You may also smell urine, a strong sense of urine. So that's a typical sign. And the most obvious is seeing the mice themselves. But with rodents, they typically are nocturnal. So you're going to have them be more active at night. They can kind of collapse their body and fit inside a hole that's about the size of a dime. So even just a small little opening, a small little gap, they can find their way in. They typically will feed on seeds, nuts, grains, but they can feed on small insects, cockroaches, things like that. But with mice, one thing to keep in mind is never underestimate the population, because they're prolific breeders. So they can have a high number of litters, usually typically 5 to 10 litters, and each litter can have up to 5 to 6 babies in each litter. So if you think about one typical female can have in a year, just think if you wait too long to take action, if you have other females become mature and they start reproducing, that population can get out of hand pretty quick. So never underestimate the population and take action as soon as you see any kind of these signs. Now, the next one that we talk about are Norway rats. So Norway rats are very much larger than the house mouse. Typically, they're going to be anywhere from 9 to 10 inches long. They'll usually have a long tail, could be up to 8 inches, but that tail is always going to be shorter than the body. They're kind of a more robust body to them, but they've got small ears, small eyes, and they've got large hind feet. And again, that's where it comes into play. If you see a baby rat, you're trying to figure out, is it a baby rat or is it a mouse? Look at the feet. That's one of the indications there. What are some things that you want to look for to see if you have Norway rats? Well, one is droppings, just similar to the house mouse. But these droppings are going to be much larger. They're going to be about 3/4 of an inch in length. And the ends are going to be more rounded or blunt. You can find gnaw damage, just like mice, damaged goods. You'll find nests, what's called grease marks, because rats typically will have a kind of an oily feel, oily film on their body. So when they rub up against something, if they do it often enough, you'll have a grease mark and it'll kind of darken that area. You may see the rats themselves, but they like to live in burrows. And you can see in this picture right here, this is a bank off of a retention pond. And you can see all the holes, and those are rat holes. Those are where they're going in and out to live. So they have a life cycle. Basically, they'll have about 3 to 6 litters a year, and they can have 4 to 7 babies in each litter. So again, once you start noticing rodents, don't underestimate the population. Another rat that you can possibly come in contact with, not so much maybe in more, the more you get into the center of the country, but along the coast or major riverways like the Mississippi, you know, you got traffic going up and down the Mississippi. So roof rats are typically known around the border area, water border areas. So they would typically be kind of a brownish to black color. They're around 8 inches long, and their tails are going to be either equivalent to their body length or longer. And that plays a part in their behavior. They've got large ears, large eyes, and hind feet. Now their droppings are going to be part of the infestation sign. So you're going to see them. They're going to be about 1/2 inch in length, but they're pointed, almost like a very large mouse dropping. But you can also see gnaw marks for damage in either structural or your damaged goods. We talked about grease marks. So if you're looking at that center picture, you'll see those dark spots on that support beam. That's where this rat has gone in and out several times. So that's what we call grease mark or rub mark. You can also find them nesting inside insulation. So the picture on the right, that's that blown insulation, that foam insulation that they use for walls or ceilings. The roof rats like to get into those. Another thing is if you're hearing sounds above you, because roof rats like to be up high. Norway rats low, roof rats up high. So if you hear noise in the attic or high areas in your building, that's something to investigate. And that's where that long tail comes in. That long tail helps the rat balance itself when it's up in those long areas. So they like to nest in high areas like the rafters, the attics. They are nocturnal, just like any other rodent. They're omnivores, so they'll mostly feed on vegetarian, they're kind of like the vegetarian of the rodents. Typically, it's going to be seeds, fruits, and they're excellent climbers. They like to be up high so they can climb better than most rodents. They'll have about 4 to 6 litters and about 6 to 8 young in each litter. So again, the point with rodents, don't underestimate their population. Look for these signs. And if you do, that's when you want to start taking appropriate action, which we'll get into.